Hi, welcome back. This is part two of the Mailchimp to Salesforce integration 9-part series. In this tutorial, we're going to learn how to automate the update for unsubscribes and bounce backs from Mailchimp to Salesforce. Currently, right now, if you don't have anything in place, your leads and contacts are not getting opted out of email if they unsubscribe from Mailchimp. We're going to show you how you can bolt on a flow that is going to automate this update for you. So let's hop over to Salesforce and let's see how this works. So first, what we're going to do is create two fields on both leads and contacts. So you'll go into Setup. You'll go to your Object Manager and then go to Lead. And then you're going to create a new field. So we already have these fields created. The first one is called Undeliverable Email Address. You can see right here, it is a checkbox field. So go ahead and create this field on your lead. You'll also create this same field on your contact. The second field that you're going to create is called MC Member Status. This field is a pick list and it has the following values: subscribed, cleaned, unsubscribed, archived, and pending. In the description below, you'll find a link to an article that is going to tell you what all the definitions are for each of these statuses. Subscribed and unsubscribed are straightforward. Cleaned basically means bounced, and archived means that you have archived it within Mailchimp. Pending means they don't have a status yet. So when you have these fields created, they should look like this on your lead and contact. Here is our checkbox, and here is our pick list. Now we're all set to create our flow. You'll go to Home, Flow, and we will create a new flow. We're going to do a record triggered flow, and our object is MC Subscriber. So if you remember from part one, the MC subscriber data is coming in from Mailchimp. And these records contain the status of the records in Mailchimp. We're going to leave all this set to the defaults, and then we're going to add a decision element here. The decision element will be called Member Status. And our first outcome is going to be called unsubscribed. And we're going to look for our unsubscribed, or we're going to look for our member status to be changed. And then the value needs to be unsubscribed. We're going to add a second outcome. It's going to be called cleaned. We're going to look for the member status to change. And then the member status needs to be cleaned. We will add a third outcome. This will be subscribed. We're looking for the member status to change. And then we're looking for the status to be subscribed. We will add a fourth outcome. And this is just going to look for the member status to be changed. And Okay, so that's it for our decision element. This is what it should look like so far. Now we're going to add an update records element. We're going to choose update related records, and this is going to be update contacts, unsubscribed. And we're going to leave this set to update records related to the MC subscriber record that triggered the flow. Here we will choose MC subscriber, and then we will scroll down and find contacts. Then we are going to set three field values. So whenever the MC subscriber status goes to unsubscribed, this means that they've opted out. So we want to set the value to the email opt-out field to true on the contact. We're going to make sure the undeliverable email address is false, because if they've unsubscribed, it's not bouncing. And then we're going to set the MC member status to be the same value, which is unsubscribed in this scenario, to the same value that's on the record in the member status field. We'll click done there. Now we're going to clone this. So we'll copy this, we'll paste it here, paste it here, we'll paste it here. And then we'll come in here and modify this. So the second one is going to be cleaned. And so if they're cleaned, they've bounced. So they didn't opt out of email, but their undeliverable email address checkbox should be checked. Okay. The second one is subscribed. And so if they've subscribed, their email opt-out should be false. Their undeliverable email address should be false. And their member status should be updated. Then if the value just changed, so remember we have two values that are archived and pending, then we just want to update the MC member status field. And then we need to rename this. Okay, that one's done. All right, we're going to save this before we go any further. So I like to name my flows with the name of the object that it's triggering from. And this is going to update leads and contacts. So this flow will update the related leads and contacts when the member status changes on the MC scrub subscriber record. Okay. Now we need to put the updates in for leads. So they're going to work exactly the same way, except we're going to choose the lead object. So this is going to be update leads, unsubscribed. And here we will choose leads. And then we'll set has opted out of email is going to be true. Our undeliverable email address should be set to false. And our member status should be equal to the member status on the MC subscriber record that triggered this flow. Okay, so now I'll copy this. Paste it here. Then we need to update these the same way we did the contacts. So this one's cleaned. All right, so has opted out of email should be false. Undeliverable email address is true because this is cleaned, so it bounced. All right, now my subscribed. All right, has opted email is false. Undeliverable email address is false. Then member status stays the same. And now my is changed. So we remove these and we just want to update the member status. All right. We save that. We have no errors, so that's good. We'll hit activate. And now we're ready to test this. So how you can test this manually without having to send an email through MailChimp and test it for real is you can go to the MC subscriber records and manually modify the status from that record. So let's go to that tab. We'll go to the app launcher. Okay, so here's all my MC subscribers. Now let's do this one right here. So let's open this one up into a new tab. Okay, and let's go to the lead. So we've got the lead on one side and we've got our record over here. All right, so let's first look at our lead. So our undeliverable email address is not checked in our MC member status is blank and our email opt-out is not checked. So if I change this to unsubscribed, I should see my member status update and my email opt-out field go to true. Right? Yep. And yep. Okay. Now let's test if I go to cleaned. So now email opt-out should be set back to false. Yep, undeliverable email address is checked because it bounced and my MC member status is cleaned. So that's perfect. Let's set this back to subscribed. Now I should see undeliverable email address get set to false, which we do, and MC member status is set to subscribed. So we're all set there. Now if we change this to pending or archived, we should see the MC member status change. All right, we're all set. So you're going to want to go through your contacts and test those same scenarios the same exact way by modifying the MC member status on the MC subscriber record. Now let's learn how we can trigger an update to all of the existing records in Salesforce, just in case you need to. You probably will. So we're going to use Data Loader and we're going to do an export. We're going to export the MC subscriber. We're going to only select the ID and the member status. Okay, we're going to view this file. And then we're going to add a column here at the end that says remove member status. Now, one thing you need to make sure that you have set in Data Loader in the settings, there is a setting called insert null values. So you need to make sure that that is checked, because what that's going to allow you to do is to overwrite data with a blank value. So now we're going to run an update and we're going to choose MC subscriber. We'll select our file, hit next. And we're going to map our member status to the blank column. Now let's get our list here. So here's our MC subscriber list. All the MC subscribers have a value in the member status field. We're going to finish. Okay, it says we had 4 successful updates, so we'll refresh this and we can see that it is blank. Now we're going to run an update to put the data back, and this will trigger our flow. You'll map the member status to the real member status this time. Okay, it says our update was successful. We'll refresh this. Our member status came back. Now let's go to one of our leads and let's check and make sure. So this is the one where the email address bounced. So we can see that our undeliverable email address is now checked and the member status is cleaned. So we have just successfully updated all of our existing records in Salesforce. That's it. That's a wrap. We hope you gained some valuable insights into how to enhance the integration between Mailchimp and Salesforce. Be sure to check out part 4, where we will show you how to sync Bouncebacks and unsubscribes from Salesforce to Mailchimp. If your users opt out a lead or a contact out of email in Salesforce, there is nothing that updates that contact in Mailchimp. You have to go and manually update them in Mailchimp. Part 3 will show you how to sync Mailchimp campaigns to Salesforce campaigns. If you are using the standard campaign object to track your other marketing initiatives like trade shows, conferences, or web forms, you will definitely want to have your emails being tracked in the same object. Be sure to check out that. If you have any questions about this video, or if you would like to see a tutorial on a different Salesforce topic, let us know in the comments below. And as always, if you like this video, be sure to like, share, and subscribe to Blue Tiger Academy. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time. Bye.